In this video, we're going to take a look at 5 things you should be considering when compositing your visual effects. These tips take place after you've shot your footage and are now bringing it into HitFilm. Let's go ahead and jump right in with tip number 5, and that is to keep an eye on your black and white levels. In this example from Rise of the Dark Side, I've got a shot of the beach. It's been filmed in log format, which is why it appears flat and colorless. If I take a look at my waveform scope, I can see that the darkest part of the video is hitting just under 10, and the brightest part is just above 50. If I add in the crashed X-Wing layer, the scope will now show the darkest part hitting 0, and the brightest hitting 100. This is because the X-Wing has been rendered in a normal color space. If I were to just continue compositing all of the other assets, the end result would be the X-Wing looking overblown in exposure, contrast, and color. There are a couple different ways you could go. You could use a LUT to match the X-Wing to the log footage, or convert the log footage to Rec. 709, which is the more standard color space. I ended up using curves and the hue, saturation, and lightness effect to dull the X-Wing down, both in brightness and overall color. As I'm doing this, I'm watching the waveform to make sure everything matches more evenly. You can find a tutorial on using curves in the card on screen. That's not to say that everything should line up perfectly. If your element should technically be brighter or darker than your footage, then you can do that. But make it so that it's not so extreme. Once the grade has been applied, the X-Wing will look much more integrated into the scene. Tip number 4 has to do with matching the color between your elements. This next example comes from our tutorial showing you how to green screen yourself into a movie trailer, in this case, Avengers Endgame. Here we've got some footage of Josh, motion tracked and keyed out, but it's immediately obvious that the colors are wrong. Looking at the waveform, he's too bright, so I'll fix that using the techniques from the last tip. The plate of Josh is now too green. This is verified by the vector scope. This cluster represents the colors of the original trailer. When I add Josh in, we get a spike that isn't lined up with the rest. I'll use curves to remove some of the green channel, then hue shift to align the colors correctly. The skin tones are an important thing to match. The vector scope is also telling me that Josh is too saturated. His line is going past the cluster. I'll use another saturation effect to dull him down just a bit. Now that the color and brightness are done, we need to continue integrating him into the scene. Technically, he should be out of focus, since he's standing a few feet back from the camera, which leads me on to my next point. Tip number 3, your camera is going to do things that you'll need to replicate in your visual effects in order for them to look properly integrated. Take a look at this shot. It's a close-up that was filmed with a 50mm lens, which has an aperture of 1.8. Very little of it is in focus. I have to keep this in mind when adding the VFX. Here's what the final shot looks like without the depth of field added. As you can see, the elements, especially the sparks, have become too obvious and distracting. They're pulling attention away from the Sith's face, which should be the main focal point. The lens blur effect allows you to use another layer as the source of the blur. I'll create a composite shot and use the color gradient effect to create a matte. The lens blur will keep the white areas in focus, and the black areas will be blurry. I'll apply the effect directly to the particle simulator layer and set the source to the matte composite. Another important one is motion blur. This can be activated on each layer by clicking this icon. The settings for motion blur can be adjusted in the Advanced tab of each composite shot's properties. Tip number 2, look out for grain and the overall quality of your footage. If you're noticing that your CG or composite is looking a bit too clean, you might need to take into consideration the actual quality of the original footage. Zoom in and look at the details of your image. Things to look out for include how sharp or soft the footage is. Use a blur or sharpen effect to match your CG to the video. Also look to see if there's grain or noise, and if so, what color it is. There are 3 effects to use for this: film grain, noise, and grain, which all use different formulas to generate the effect. Use whichever works best for your footage. And tip number 1 has to do with the final grade layer, which goes on top. This layer is where I bring the composite together, add my color grade, as well as any final lighting or blurring effects. So it's important for me to keep in mind when compositing that even if it's not looking so great right now, there are still a lot of things I can do in this one layer that will bring it up to that final finished quality. So my tip is this: remember that the color grade can and probably will have a big effect on the composite. That's it for today. Hopefully this video helps you make better looking composites. Let us know if you have any tips or comments down below, and I'll see you all in the next video.